Everybody, Bud Brown here. Oh, kind of hot and humid here in the Philippines. Oh, that was dumb. But anyway, it is humid here. Hey, I'm going to make a video here in response to a subscriber who made a comment, and let me see if I can find those comments so you can see. Yeah, her name is Cece Misa, and she said, may I request a video explaining the difference between Hindi and Wolof? Making sentences can get confusing. For example, he is not here. You use Wolof. Why? Oh, very good. Very good. Very good question. Okay, here's the deal. And this is why English speakers get in trouble with these two words. Because in English, we can say, do you have money? No. Are you hot and humid there in the Philippines? Yes. Oh, look up. I want an example to say no. Is it freezing there in the Philippines? No. Are you cold there? No. Do you have money? No. All these answer with one word, no. But in Tagalog, you can use Hindi or Wolof. And I'm going to tell you exactly why. So at the end of this video, you're going to say, ah, I understand now. Okay. In Tagalog, there's one word for to have or to exist, and that's maron. So, may pera ka ba? You have money. And if you're talking about having something or existing something, something existing, you know, speak English too good, then the negative answer is Wolof. Wolof means nothing or no have. Do you have money? No have. Is the man there? No exist. No have. Wolof. But if you say, ma'init ka? Are you hot? Well, that kind of has two different connotations. But are you cold? Malamig ka ba? Then you say, Hindi ko malamig. I'm not cold. So if you're asking, do you have something? And you want to give the negative answer, don't have, it's Wolof. May aso ka? Do you have a dog? Wolof. No, I don't have one. No have. What other example? I want to say something without don't have or don't. Do you speak Chinese? Marunong ka mag-Chinese? Mag-insek? Hindi. No, I don't. Do you have a car? May kotse ka ba? Wolof. Don't have. So, oh, this is a crazy video. But anyway, think of it this way to summarize. If the question begins with, maron ka bang, do you have? Then the answer, Wolof. Or maron. Meaning yes, but it means I have. May lalaki sa pintuan? Is there a man at the door? Wolof. Or mayroon lalaki doon. There is a man there. Honey, may bisita ka? Honey, you have a visitor. Lalaki ba? Is it a man? Hindi, babae. It's a woman. Honey, may pera ka ba? Honey, do you have any money? Wolof. Palagi Wolof. Okay, so hopefully all my rambling, you can understand the difference between hindi, no, and Wolof, no have. or no exist. Okay. My mind wants to keep giving more examples, but if you don't get it, then I can give more examples. Talk to you later. Something else funny I'm going to do here. How was this lesson? All right. Very good. Thank you. Talk to you later. Bye-bye. Hi, everybody. Bud Brown again. Still living in the Philippines. Yeah. Hey, I did remember something else I wanted to mention about the words Hindi and voila. If you want to something that you were going to do or you used to like, but it's not anymore, you would say Hindi na. For example, if my wife says, "Honey, gusto mo sumama sa akin sa karkar?" I would say, "Hindi, ayoko na." Sabi mo kanina gusto mo sumama? Hindi na. Hindi na. No, not anymore. Did you want to go with me to karkar? No, I don't want to. You said you wanted to go. No, not anymore. No more. Hindi na. So, it's the same thing, the same idea, but Hindi means everything outside of existing or using up something. If she asked me if I have money, no, no more money. But you had money before. Well, no more. It's all gone. So it would go like this. Bigyan mo ako pera. Wala kong pera. May pera ka kanina. Oo, pero wala na. Wala na ba? Wala na. I had money, but no more. Wala na. Okay, and that is goodbye for sure on this tape. See you later. Bye.